Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Here we have a building plan. What plan is this? As you all know, this is the plan of the big architecture AI city. It was a bit long to prepare this plan, so I have prepared this as a preliminary for you. The only differences with the original building is grid system. In the original building, the grid system was designed for 3 meters, but in this plan, the grid system was designed for 2 meters. Therefore, our building is a little small according to the original. Our 3D is something like this, and our elevation heights are 225. And we are going to fulfill this building with the roof, and of course, it will be similar with the original design. Let's get started. Alright, if we look at the original building, we will see planes stacked on top of each other. But also, every plane is part of a sphere. Therefore, at the very first, we are going to create a sphere. And as you guess, we are going to use shell tool in ARCHICAD. At the beginning of this, we are going to search for center point for the shell. Therefore, we are going to determine our borders. We are gonna connect these corners and find out our center point. Maybe we can make a plus like so. There we go. And when we have this, we can go to shell tool. At the beginning, I want to change the structure type to simple. And as for the geometry method, I'm gonna choose this revolved. Let's click that and leave the construction method as is. Thickness is 30, it's okay. And as ARCHICAD said, it says enter revolved shell center point. Okay, let's do that. Here we have center point and end point. Something like this. And we are going to fulfill our circle and complete the shape. There we go. We have our first level. Let's go back to the reference picture and we are going to create three additional roof plates in different layers. At the very first, we are going to change and organize first and duplicate. In order to achieve that, first we are going to create a section. Here we have section tool. And from the center part, I'm gonna create a section layer like this. And right click, open with current view settings. In the original building, we have four building level, but in our building, we are going to have two. So let's go back to the floor plan and duplicate. Ctrl plus C, go to the first story and paste. Let's go back to the section and arrange our roof. Let's select our roof and we will see reference axis, center line and revolve line. We can change this corner's position by clicking that and clicking this move node. Like so. I'm gonna mesh this top part to here. And after that, I'm gonna click this blue revolve line and change the curve shape with this edit segment using tangent. As you can see, I have clicked the part where is the nearest to the center point. With that, my tangent editing point is attached to center point. And with the shift key and making a simple line and by clicking, we will have a very smooth tangent roof shell. Okay, now we are going to copy this from the floor plan. For instance, with the center point to the left. And also one more time. Because we are going to create different rectangular shapes, and when top of each other, they can be accidentally intersected when we are arranging them. Now, let's just click our shell, and this time we are going to use different way, which is creating holes in shell. With that, this is going to be a bit longer process, but this will do the trick. We are going to right click the shell again and define shell contour again, and this will be our first border. It goes to here. And we go down to this way and turn to here. And we are going to close the shape. Like so. And this time, we are going to use create hole in shell. While doing this, we are going to use shift key. With the shift key, we can create easily straight lines. There we go. Now we just need some offset onto it. Not this one, because I don't want to offset all of the edges. There we go. Now we are going to create our second level. Let's just leave this one as is. And we can go with this part and move to its original position in the building section. We can change its elevation, or instead of that, we can reduce our first part elevation. The process is the same. At the first, we are going to determine outer borders. And inside borders. like so, and offset for the eaves. There we go. This was our second level. And now we can model our third level. This is going to be the most easiest because we only have two rectangular shapes. Let's go back to the section and change layers, levels, or let's go back to the 3D window, select the first one, second one, and move an additional 100 centimeter. But when you are selecting that, just be careful not to select inside borders. We are going to select outside borders. Not this. Like this. Let's do that one by one. There we go. By the way, we did some mistake here. As you can see, our eaves are not in their position. Let's fix it. Let's fix them. This happens because while moving their elevation in the 3D window, we accidentally hold the interior parts, not the whole shell model. There we go. One more here. Okay. Let's continue. And let's cut out more holes for the last part. Right click and click the not this one. Here, this guy, define shell contour, and let's start from here. Not center, please. Here, and continue with the create hole in shell. There we go. Once you have that, the last step will be creating Eves. One more here, and here we have a corner, and connect these guys with each other. I think we need one more node here. With these nodes, we can offset this part separately, like this. All right, all is well. And as you guess, last step will be getting rid of the upper parts for the walls. In order to achieve that, let's just alt click all of the walls and hit Ctrl plus A, right click, connect, and go with the solid element operations and click add as target. And this time we are going to select all of the shell, and these are going to be operator, and we are going to choose subtraction with upward extrusion and execute. And this is what we have. And if we create a simple model with shadow, we are going to get something like this. If you want to change the height of the building, you can just go to ground floor or another floor to story settings, and you can change these values. For instance, 500 here and 500 here too, and click OK. Or instead of that, you can select all of the shell and move, for instance, 200 centimeters, like so. And after this step, you can easily create doors, windows, openings, and whatever you want according to your similar project or design. And as for this building, we have, of course, more levels here, some openings, and terrace, and interior gardens. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. If so, please do not forget to hit the like button and do not forget to subscribe if you want to get similar tutorials like this. In addition to that, if you want to download this project files, you can always find this and also my other project tutorial files in my Patreon page. In there, you can also find bonus video tutorials. Again, thank you for watching. Have a nice day.